think it's extra special when someone gets to step in that historic circle for the very first time, and you're all going to be a part of that right now.
Hey, John, how are you?
I'm doing good. How are you?
Big night for you, sir.
Yeah, that's what I hear.
It's pretty crazy just thinking 4 or 5 years ago. It was just a chance of me leaving North Carolina and not knowing what I was getting into, really. What's up, y'all? This is John Morgan, and I'm making my Opry debut. I had a meeting at the label. Some of my team was like, yeah, we got some things to show you. I got a computer in front of me. Up pops Carrie Underwood.
Hey, John, Carrie here. I just wanted to send you a little message and make sure that you didn't have plans on May 19th because I just heard from our good buddy, Jason Aldean, that you have been invited to make your grand ol' Opry debut. I am so excited for you. It is truly a magical place and I hope you have the best night.
Okay. All right. Yeah, that made the morning a little better. Wow, that's awesome. I don't know what to say. I feel like the Grand Ole Opry, to people who aren't in Nashville, it's like this untouchable thing almost. It means a whole lot to me, and especially my family, my friends, my bandmates. It's even sweeter to get to do it with my guys. Definitely a bucket list thing that we've had. That's a dream come true.
Moving to Nashville was a faraway dream for me several years ago. Took a big chance and moved down here, and the Lord has blessed me and given me so many opportunities to live out my dream and be able to finally make a few dollars doing this every once in a while.
There was a time in my life where I just kind of quit music for a while. I kind of got burnt on a few situations that I thought were going to pan out to be something and dropped it for, I guess, about a year. Then I just started picking it back up and writing with some of my buddies back home. Rob, my drummer, now we used to sit in my dad's workshop and try to write songs or like start ideas and stuff. And he's really kind of one of the guys that kind of got me back into it. He moved here about a year before me. He's like, bro, you just come down and try writing with people and see what happens. And I was like, man, I don't know. I'm very much a homebody. The thought of picking up and moving my life to a different big city, which I'm from a small little country town, and I didn't really honestly think it was a possibility to make music my career until I got to Nashville. Nashville's an intimidating place at first because everybody here is talented.
Glad to be here.
Nothing like it.
Huh.
Especially the first time.
I'm John.
Danny.
Nice to meet you.
And that's Kevin over there.
How you doing, Kevin?
So tell us what you need out of us.
Y'all sure it. I'm just going to try to worry about remembering my lyrics
that's
tonight.
Always a good idea.
Yeah, this is my pick bag. I can keep up with this for about 5 years, but I lose sunglasses and wallet every day. So.
Well, it's a fancy pick bag.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, it's a treasure for sure.
Long story short, ended up getting in an Uber one day. My Uber driver was like, you know, I'm a songwriter in town. I've been writing for a while. I was like, cool, man. You know, you take it with a grain of salt. He was like, yeah, I had a couple Jason Aldean cuts back in the day. About a year after that, I had picked up a side gig working over here at Opry Mills at Lucky Brand. I was out there working and this guy walks in, realizing that he was my Uber driver from a year earlier. I just kind of told him what I was doing. He was like, well, send me some stuff you're working on. One thing led to another. He ended up setting me up with a write with Jason Aldean's bandmates.
Met John Morgan through a friend named Jonathan Edwards. He called and said, hey, you met this kid and they started writing a song and would we want to come in on it and finish it with them. So he sent the song, it was like a verse and a little piece of a chorus, and I said, yeah, the song's great. Man, who's singing that? And he goes, that's a new friend, John Morgan.
I'm tore up like a whiskey label, staring at the key that you left on the table. Hate to tell you, baby, but you got it wrong.
They ended up sending it to Jason as a pitch. About a week later, I was outside at the house and I get a phone call and it's a 615 number. And I usually don't answer if I don't know who it is, but thank God I did. It was Jason Aldean, and he was like, hey man, I just love what you're doing. Started this new publishing company and record label and love for you to be a part of it. And so the rest is kind of history from that point. I just have been fortunate enough to get a couple cuts on his last couple albums. And my first cut was If I Didn't Love You with him and Carrie Underwood. That song bought a lot of diapers for my little girl, so I'm thankful for that one.
Doing all right, but the shape I'm in, sitting by the fire with some damn good friends. Willie on my left, Jack on my right. Rolling that smoke on a Friday night. Well, I'm turned up on the JBL, girl. You probably think I'm going through hell, but I don't care if I never come back. Cause who needs you? Man, I got friends like that.
He knows who he is, he's genuine, he doesn't let anything cloud that moment of what he is and what he wants to be. For tonight, he knows, as long as he's himself, that translates.
Will you welcome John Morgan?
About this time you and I be tangled up.
Yeah, but that's all right. This fire's been keeping me warm enough. Well, holding on to you, girl, who needs that? I got a wide knuckle grip on a whiskey glass. Now, when it gets down to ice, I just fill it back up.
For me, I just hope that I can do justice to all the history, all the people who've crossed through that stage. It's definitely surreal. It's a cool feeling to finally be here.
Yeah, girl, I got friends like that. Yeah, I got friends like that.
John Morgan, everybody.